Bermuda 851, turn right, heading 180. Papa, turn right 245. Report localizer established.
If we're to say there's an unlucky carrier in aviation, I think a lot of us could agree on it being Norwegian, an airline that has seen almost every major problem regarding engines and or aircraft in the past year directly impact them also. From the 737 MAX crisis to before the Trent 1000 engine issues, which saw Package B and also Package C engines impacted. However, the issues don't appear to be slowing down, thanks to a new, rather alarming finding. Last weekend, a Boeing 787-8 with Norwegian made an emergency landing into Rome. Now, it was actually supposed to fly from Rome to Los Angeles, but sadly didn't make it very far, and shortly after departing Rome, had to return due to engine problems. These problems saw 25 vehicles, 12 houses, and one person, according to Forbes, hit by falling debris coming from the sky. Many onlookers enjoying their summer in Rome spoke to local media and said how if the debris had come down any earlier, it would have not only hit the city centre, but also likely the beaches, which, as we know, are extremely popular at this time of the year. The tweet on your screen now, which will also be linked into the sources and information area of the description, showcases the debris and ultimately the damage it made to what looks to be the windscreen of a car. It's worth noting that the Norwegian 787 reached some 3,000 feet before returning to Rome, which is enough for the debris to pick up an enormous amount of pace. And while being small debris, thanks to their overall speed, their land was heavy, creating major damage. The Italian Aviation Safety Agency, or simply ANSV, has already launched an investigation into the incident. The plane, which is actually registered as LN-LTD, does have the Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 engines attached, and is only actually 5 years old. As always, when a body like the Italian Aviation Safety Agency conducts an investigation, they also extend their investigation to other parties. Similar to the A380 wing cracks, there's no doubt this investigation will stretch to other airlines who use the Trent 1000, and in addition to Rolls-Royce, to better understand how they manufacture their engines and whether it was an issue that originated from the manufacturing process. Ultimately, this could just be a simple issue with one engine, or it could not. However, it would be wrong of me to completely ignore something like this, which I know is of great interest to so many people here on the channel, especially as the Trent 1000 topic has been covered extensively here on the channel in the past year or so. What are your thoughts on this? Do you believe it's an isolated incident? Or do you think the Trent 1000 engine is still having some little niggly problems that it simply just can't pass? Do let me know down in the comment section below. And as always, thank you very much for tuning into another one of my videos. I do very much look forward to you all joining me in the next one.